A very good morning, dear students. I hope you all are fine. So in today's session, we are continuing with chapter 4, Windows operating system. In last session, we have covered till some operation options of Windows. Today we are going to start with next topic, that is some short terms are there. Like first term, it is taskbar. What is the use of taskbar? Why we are using taskbar? Taskbar is located on the computer screen at the bottom. It means if you are having this screen, it is located at the bottom corner. This bar is known as taskbar. At the bottom, it is a horizontal bar, and left to right, what is available in taskbar? Start button is on this corner. Some shortcuts are on in between. Afterward, minimize file will be there, and afterward some sound, printer and date and time options are there. It means the bottom line of your desktop window is known as taskbar. What is tab menu? Tab menu, it is always present in a dialog box. Suppose we are clicking on any option like my computer, we are having icon my computer. When we are clicking on my computer, we will get a dialog box. That dialog box is known as tab menu. That will contain the page information about the page, what we have opened, how it will be work, how it can be cut, how it can be copied, how it can be paste. All the options in tab menu are presented in dialog box. Next is opening and closing options. If you want to open a specific application, for opening a specific application, click on start button. Afterward, type the name of application. Suppose you want to open MS Word, so type MS Word and do double click or enter. That specific program will be open. To open a program, two options are there. Either you can press double click by searching a file, otherwise you can press enter key by searching from start button. Because you can open the file from start button also, you can open the file from any drive also, you can open the file from desktop window also. How to close the application? To close the application, we are having three options. On the right top corner, cross button is there. That is used to close an application. Second, you are looking on the screen on this corner. It is the cross button, that is for closing the application. Second, you can use shortcut key, that is Alt plus F4. And third is you will click on file and you will select the quit option or exit option is there. This is to close the application. Next is how to manipulate the windows. It means you are having a window screen, how we can do manipulation in that screen area. So we can perform four operations on a window. First option that can be used for manipulation, that is known as minimize. Second is known as maximize. Third is known as resize, and fourth is known as close. Minimize is to minimize the screen. Minimize the screen. And maximize is to full screen, to display on full screen area. And resize means to say, if you want to adjust the width and height, it helps to adjust width and height according to the user requirement. And close button we have recently done, it is used to close the application. So first one is minimize, and the sign that is used, that is single. Second is full screen, that is known as maximize, it is a square box. And third one is resize, it is a double square box. And fourth one is close button. So in this chapter we have studied about now till taskbar, tab menu, opening and closing application, and manipulating the windows. Now next topic is using the computer folder. How to use the computer folder with my computer folder. Just click on start button and click. So which operations can be performed on a window explorer? It means the view of window is visible. Which type of operations can be performed? What are the folders? Different options are there. Navigation pane is there, detail pane is there, preview pane, library pane, toolbar, address bar and search bar. So what is the use of navigation pane? Very first thing, navigation pane is the left side of Windows Explorer. If you are looking the view of window, in that side some options are given. Options are favorite, library, home group, computer and network. All such options are under navigation pane that are on the left side of your my computer option. Next is detail pane. Detail pane, it will show the property of current folder selection. Whatsoever file you have selected, it will show its property, which property is applied on specific file. It will show the detail of that file. Next is preview pane. Preview pane is used to show or hide the view of document. It means it will show the view how it will be displayed after taking the final printout of document. It is known as preview pane. And library pane, it is used to arrange the files and its different properties. Library pane contains the list of files and folders, and it is a helpful tool to maintain different properties if we want to change any property. So library pane is good to change its properties. Toolbar. Toolbar will help to changing the appearance of files and folders. How it will be displayed? It will be displayed in small icon, large icon, extra large icon, thumbnail. These all are the concept of toolbar. And next is address bar. As the name suggests, address bar is used to navigate different files and folders. Like currently we are working on desktop and we want to switch in C drive. So we can directly move in C drive by using the address bar. Just write in address bar C drive and press enter, you can directly move to C drive. And search box. Search box, as the name suggests, it is an entity to search a specific item in current file or folder. Like you are currently in D drive and you want to search the file A, B, C. So what will you do? You will write. You will click in D drive. Afterward, you will open the search box that is on right corner this side. And you will write A, B, C and you will press on go option and it will search the specific file or folder is available or no. This is the concept of search box option. So in this we have studied about navigation pane, details pane, preview pane, library pane, toolbar, address bar and search box tool. Now next topic is control panel. What is the use of control panel and how we can use it? Control panel is the system manager that is used to perform different types of settings. Control panel can be used for the purpose of add or remove any hardware or software device. It will help to add or remove any hardware and software device, and the benefit is there. We can install and uninstall from control panel directly, and file will be directly removed from all location if we are uninstalling from this position. We can do the date and time setting. If date and time is not matching, you can do change from there. We can use the system setting that is related to the user account. Maximum we can create 5 users accounts. We can maintain 5 users. Changing the system setting, we can perform the setting of keyboard. We can change the setting of ports. We can change the setting of network. We can change the setting of connector. So it is the part of system setting. Next is changing keyboard and mouse setting. If you want to use keyboard as a mouse, or if you want to do some changes in keyboard setting, if you want to do changes in mouse setting like click event, single click, double click, that all are possible in control panel. And system administration, how to perform the system, how to manage the system, how to use the system, who will be the admin of computer system, that all settings are present in control panel option. And it is most important question as per your point of your final examination. So learn it very carefully. Now next topic is using files and folders. How to use the files and folders? In a specific file, we can perform four operations. We can search data within a file, we can create a new folder, we can delete a folder, or we can rename a folder. How to search a file? For searching a file, just click on start button, type the file name, type file name, and press enter key. It will search the specific file and provide the, what it will provide? It will provide the path where this file is available, provide the location. This is the search. Second is to create a folder. How to create a folder? To create a folder, just click on specific location where you want to create. It means find the location. Afterward, click on right click mouse button. On right click, select the new option. In new, select the folder option. After selecting folder, rename and press enter. This is the procedure to create a file or to create a folder. At first, you need to click on the specific location where you want to create a specific file or folder. Then press right click, then select new folder option, specific location, right click, new option, in new folder option. Afterward, type the name of folder and press enter key to save the specific folder. It is the concept to create a folder. How to delete a folder? So again, select the folder which will be deleted and then press del key. For which purpose? To temporarily delete. If you want to delete it permanently, then select the folder and then use shift plus del. It will delete permanently. In which data will delete permanently? In which data will go to the recycle bin folder? How to rename a folder? Same steps are there. For renaming a folder, you have to press right click on folder. Then select the rename option. Then type the name, type name, and press enter. This is the process to rename a folder. So after covering this part, chapter 4 is completed. In next session, we will study about next part of this chapter, that is exercise part. In this session, we have covered chapter 4 complete. Thank you. Have a nice day for this session. Thank you so much.